Oh boy, thanks so much for coming out tonight. Great crowd, really, thank you. Give yourselves a round of applause. I hope you enjoyed the dress rehearsal as we were doing our mic check. That was very, very exciting. Actually, it wasn't. I was quite stressed. But as they say, the show must go on. So again, thank you for coming out. We really appreciate you coming out this evening to our final concert of the season. As you know, we are the Loudoun Symphonic Winds, and we're really excited to present on the second half of our program, our guest artist for this year, the Breaking Winds. Very excited. So we opened up with a march that was actually to commemorate Thomas Joyce, who founded the 71st Regimental Band. And actually, this was a band that was formed shortly after the Civil War. And basically, it was a support band for what is now known today as the New York National Guard. Now, for our next selection, we're going to perform a work by the Russian composer Dmitri Shostakovich. And he's considered one of the most controversial Russian composers of all time. Now, he achieved his fame during a time that we had the Soviet Union, which was a time of censure and oppression. And although he received many accolades for his compositions, a lot of support from the government, his relationship with the government was actually not all that peachy. In other words, he wasn't really supportive of the regime. So in his own way, with his music, you know, he did things to voice his opposition. Probably the most famous work of all is his Fifth Symphony, where he really used the music to kind of emulate the suppression and oppression of the Russian government at that time. But tonight we're going to perform a different work for you. We're going to perform an overture known as the Festive Overture, and he actually wrote this piece, or he was required, that is, to compose this piece to commemorate the 1917 October Revolution. That's a revolution of which when Lenin took over and communism really came into being. Now, this, what's really interesting about this work is that he composed it in only 3 days, which is a rather amazing feat in itself. So the piece itself is going to open up with a brass fanfare, and it's going to be followed by a rapid-paced melody in the woodwinds and all the different sections of the band take over. We really think you're going to enjoy this. Again, this is Shostakovich's Festive Overture.
Thank you.
So much. Oh, that was so much fun. A lot of fun. All right. Now for our next piece, we're going to do a piece. This is by a Hungarian composer by the name of Franz Liszt. Now the name is German because he did most of his work in Germany, but he was born in Hungary. And he is very much influenced by the Hungarian music. Now this particular work we're going to perform is actually one of a collection of rhapsodies. But let me tell you a little bit about Franz Liszt first. So, he lived during the time of Beethoven, and actually Beethoven was one of his teachers, and he was a pianist as well, like Beethoven, but he wanted to be known as a virtuoso pianist on the same level as one of his contemporaries, Paganini, was on the violin. And today, even as of today, he is still known as probably one of the greatest piano virtuosi of all time. So back to the piece we're going to play for you. So again, I told you about his Hungarian influences. And so he wrote a series of, 19 rhapsodies. And this particular piece is probably the most famous of the set, number 2. I think you're gonna enjoy this piece. And actually another thing is, this piece itself is so famous that how many of you remember Warner Brothers, the Warner Brothers cartoons? Raise your hands. Okay, so I have a homework assignment for you. Over the weekend, get on YouTube. Who doesn't know what YouTube is? I dare you to raise your hand. Okay. So go on YouTube and just do a search for Hungarian Rhapsody Tom and Jerry. And you will find this just amazing cartoon of Tom and Jerry doing the Hungarian Rhapsody. And it's the most amazing thing. Now, I do have to warn you, we're not going to play quite like they do. But we're going to have our own sense of excitement in itself. We hope you enjoy this. This is Hungarian Rhapsody No. 2 by Franz Liszt.
Thank you.
How many of you recognize that song? Raise your hand. Aha! So how many's gonna go on YouTube tomorrow and find Tom and Jerry? Oh boy, you need to check it out. It's absolutely amazing. But I thought we were pretty amazing too. What do you think? Thank you. You know, we can go back generations to find numerous works that commemorate those who sacrificed their lives for the freedoms of all. You have Benjamin Britten's War Requiem, you have Aaron Copland's Fanfare for the Common Man, and for some of us more elderly folks, some of you may remember the NBC television series called Victory at Sea. Now, what all of these things have in common is that the idea of using music to really commemorate, represent the ultimate sacrifice for the betterment of humankind. Now tonight, we're going to perform an excerpt from the soundtrack of Steven Spielberg's Saving Private Ryan. And this excerpt we're going to perform for you, and as you know, the composer for that the soundtrack was John Williams. And who doesn't know John Williams? So this piece we're going to play for you is actually one that honors those who gave their lives during the D-Day landings of World War II. This is Hymn to the Fallen. Thank you. Thank you very much. Before we close out the first half of our program, we just want to let you know we do have some refreshments out in the hallway, so please partake. We accept donations, but please don't bring any food and drink back into the hall following intermission, so we'd appreciate that very much. And the concessions will also be open a little bit after the concert's over as well. And I know how many of you are excited to see the Breaking Winds coming in the second half. You know, I'm not sure how excited you really are. How excited are you? Oh, okay. All right, wonderful. So we're going to close out with a medley of marches, some of Sousa's more famous marches. And it's actually a very creative collection of some of those marches by a well-known arranger by the name of Warren Barker. We hope you enjoy this, and we will see you following the intermission. This is Sousa.